I'm Scott Corrali. I'm the design director for Animal Cove,
otherwise known as Boss to me. I am a game designer on Animal Cove working on level design specifically.
I don't really get to work on levels anymore.
But yeah, the original levels were all you.
You get to have all the fun.
That's right. The levels don't start getting really good till about 150.
Right after I stopped working on them.
And right when I started working on them.
Thanks. Right? That's good. Thank you, Tom.
700.
Yes.
Wait, we should do that more naturally. 700
levels.
700 levels.
First of all, may I say that I would claim Twinkle Star, the unicorn, because unicorn, hello. But yes, my wife got Twinkle Star, and I'm burnt inside because I don't have Twinkle Star yet, and Twinkle Star is very difficult to get. I guess I would have to say my mythical animal I'm after is Nessa, because Loch Ness Monster, Nessa, right? In fact, could I get some coins for Nessa by doing this interview?
My favorite is Mackie.
Mackie the Mack Truck. No. What is Mackie?
Mackie the Snow Leopard.
Mackie the Snow Leopard.
Yes.
Are we still filming?
No.
Okay. Are we doing a blooper reel?
I can't do this.
I actually have looked at this because we look at the stats. And there is one particular level that I found is taking people an average of 12 to 13 tries.
That's a little above our threshold
there,
Tom. It's
pretty amazing, right? Yeah. But, you know, people aren't leaving the game because of it, because they really enjoy the level.
All right,
which
so
means
it's a
fun
good, level.
It's a fun level, okay. Right? And this one was not designed by me. This was designed by Andrew Rehm, and it is devious, right? So what it is it's a starfish level, and you have to get starfish through a whole series of tubes, right? I would call them tubes. There's little teleporters, they drop down. There's walls in between the sections. It's got like different, you know, only four color matches in the corners, and there's five color matches. It's really complex and beautiful, right? You did a good job. But the devious thing about it is, after you get those two starfish all the way down, and in between there's all these shells and sand and madness, right? Then another little starfish pops up at the back, and you have to get that last starfish
not done yet.
All the way through, and it is just
deviously designed.
637.
Oh, wow, yeah, that's in the high end there.
It's a high end one, yeah. For me personally, my hardest level is 599.
You made that one?
I made that one. Now, I name all my levels. I'm a little unusual that way.
He doesn't just name them, he creates little summaries.
Sure, little summaries, little stories. It's all right. But this is not my best name, because I named this one Hedgehog Watermelon Thievery. Now, that's not my best name, right? You've seen some of my names.
I have.
My best name is probably, what did I write? Terror Droids Treasure Blasters.
Yeah.
That's a cool name.
That happened.
Actually, it takes players about 8 to 9 times to do it. It has all the little hedgehog coins that you have to collect around the very outer edge. You can't get them except for by eggs. Then the next level I have a whole bunch of nests surrounding it, right?
Interesting.
But there's beach towels covering the last half of the board that require watermelon, right? So you start to collect watermelon, but in doing so, you accidentally touch these nests, which blow up and collect the coins, which gets the hedgehog moving, and eventually the hedgehog starts bumping its head against those beach towels because it can't get through them because you lose speed trying to get watermelons, right?
Yeah.
$5.99. Otherwise known as Hedgehog Watermelon Thievery.
Mm.
Internally, to me, only.
Everyone loved the baby animal system so much, and then we created the mythical babies, which are even harder to collect. We wanted to give them a proper home. All the other animals can roam around in the normal environment, but the mythicals are so special, it felt like they needed something to match that, and so we made a whole island just for them.
Here we go!
Very dramatic cutscene. Now that is a proper unicorn home.
That's awesome.
Yes, it is indeed awesome. Another reason for Mythical Island is that players really took to Infinity Mode. Infinity Mode is something that kicks in whenever you reach the end of the level content. You get to keep playing match 3 levels because it'll randomly select from the entire library of levels that we have. Because players love earning the keys, the golden keys, and Infinity Mode used to not be able to grant keys.
Yep.
But now it does, and those keys can now be used on Mythical Island to unlock all sorts of cool stuff.
With these really fancy, easy, you know, magic ovens here,
and you can create all these cool treats. Over here on the Tasty Treats menu, you have an incredible shop here on the right where we have these cool prizes. Mythical Island is excellent home for the mythical babies and a perfect way to let content just kind of continue forever and just let players play match 3 levels and unlock all sorts of really cool stuff on the island.
And you get to cook there.
You do get to cook.
Well, we got something really cool called clubs. I am in an amazing club. Shout out to Des Heads. Could you give me some coins to donate to my club?
Look, he already
for
told
doing
you
the interview.
Can't help you.
Clubs are great because you go in every day, you get a free ticket. You can play a club level. We recently put in more club levels.
We did.
And collect gems. And once you get those gems, those are gathered for your club. They go into a pot. You get prizes that are kind of in a tiered fashion. And you try to get all the way up to the top.
Yep.
Prize.
Everyone works together. Animal Cove is a really great single player game, but we wanted to allow a little bit more social interaction. Clubs lets you join a group of 25 players and you guys can all chat in game, which helps a lot because players sometimes have questions. They want to know about different tips and strategies for beating hard levels. You can always go to the forums, but now you've got something in game. So now you can talk to your club and ask for help. Every week, the club can work together towards a common goal. And depending on how well they do, they get rewarded for it. There's 3 different prizes you can earn based on how well you do for the week, and then when it's over, it resets and starts again.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but the higher your club level, the better those
prizes. The better those prizes, and the better stuff you can get from the club shop.
Yes.
And the club shop has some pretty awesome baby animals in it as well.
Exclusive baby animals you can only get for your club.
Yep. Yeah. I wonder if anyone has the lion yet.
I don't know. Because
the lion is locked behind club level 4. And you mentioned yours was club level 2.
We're going to have marketing do some research
on
that.
You need to get to work on that.
I do. I need to donate more, so if you could give me more coins.
And if you can get that lion, it makes the lions part of the safari set. And so whenever the baby animal challenge comes up, you have more power from safari. You can get further in that challenge and get those mythical babies even quicker.
After you've hit infinity mode, just going around the Animal Cove world.
Clicking on all the goodies.
Clicking on all the things, making them make sounds, and you can change them by, I don't know if a lot of people know this.
That's a really good point.
If you click and hold down on a decoration, you can pay a little bit of coin. It's a very small
Super
amount.
Super small. Yeah.
And change its look. So if you aren't happy with your choice that you made while playing the game, you
can change
that. Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of players aren't aware of that, but you can change every single thing on your island. If you've anything you've unlocked, Amanda's pagoda, Adonis's weight bench, or the entire deck that he works out on, all those things can be changed out. Kitchens in the food court. Whatever option you chose first, you're not always stuck with that. You can swap to any of the stuff, and the art team has made incredible options for all those things that look really cool.
You have a tip? You have a good tip?
No, you do. Match 3 oriented, right?
Actually, the game gives you a really good tip in that it will select one piece for you to move, and usually that's at the bottom of the board.
Mm-hmm.
That's a hint for players in a way, because if you make matches near the bottom of the play board, it actually will cause more cascades, as we call them, of objects making matches on their own for you. So if you make one match and you happen to get 2 or 3, or even like cascade into a bomb, that's awesome.
Yep, right? It improves your chances. And just, save those boosters for the hard levels and very hard levels. That's exactly why we label them. If it's a very hard level, it's going to be very hard.
Right.
So use your boosters on that, you'll be able to get through quicker.
Oh, you know what? Eggs. Make lots and lots of eggs. There's certain levels where eggs are even more powerful.
We'll let them know how to even make an egg.
Yeah, I don't know. Do they know how to make an egg?
Just tell them.
Okay, so making an egg, which you can't do in many match 3s, is combine 4 into a square, right? And when you make that square, it goes into an egg. And that egg, when you make a match with it of the same color, seeks out the objective that's on the board. So say you have shells as one of your objectives. Mm-hmm. It just seeks out that shell and destroys it. So it can be very powerful on specific levels.
Oh, they're very powerful on all levels, but some you really need to use them. But yeah, make those eggs.
So what happens if you move an egg onto another egg?
When you fuse 2 of those eggs together, you will get 3 chickens that come out and seek objectives. And if you can if you can manage to swap or fuse 2 eggs of the same color together, you get 4 chickens.
Yeah.
And they'll go out and seek different objectives for you. So that's some pretty pro play right there, but it's a good tip.
Chicken attack, chicken attack. Do you remember that song?
Yes, this is happening.
Chicken attack.
Woo, Tom, good stuff.
Chicken attack.
All right, cool.